Movie Fights, Schmoedown. I want every belt. I want to get in shape and fight in the WWE. I want to win all their belts, too. I want to have a wall of belts.
Dan Murrell has the belt through this entire run. They've all just been in the way of the belt. And what did I say after Bespin? I was coming back for that belt. That's all I care about. That's all I want.
Welcome back to the Movie Trivia Schmoedown, a very big special event. We are going to end Title League today with a big one. I'm Christian Arlo.
I am Mark Ellison. Christian, I got a full cup of Bartles and James because the culmination of Championship Week goes down right now with a headliner match for the ages.
Listen, it has all come to this. John Rocha, the Outlaw, is going for that title that he has been talking about since day one. And he's got to do it against quite possibly the best who's ever played the game, Dangerous Dan Murrell. That happens tonight. It's going to be a big matchup. People have been talking about this match. They have been going at it on Twitter. They have been talking. They're screaming and yelling at each other. You've played both of these guys. How are you feeling about this?
I mean,
tonight?
Look, not since I wanted to be a black belt in karate have I seen a young man sweat so hard to put something around his waist as John Rocha wanting this thing. He wants this more than any, the touch of a woman, a successful career. All he wants is that belt, and guess who has it? Dan Murrell, the guy who he's seen in his nightmares. Now, I've been in the ring against John Rocha, and the guy can psych himself out. I didn't have to do a lot of work that day, Christian, because he gets so worked up for the matches, he seems to overhype himself. Dan Murrell comes in cool as ice. He's like Mr. Freeze from the classic Batman and Robin.
Well, on the counter to that, I've also played John Rocha, and I played a very focused John Rocha. I played a guy that just wanted to do nothing except focus on trivia. So which Rocha will we see tonight? That's the question. But before we even get into that, we have an undercard. And what a great undercard we have today, because we have two rising stars in the Movie Trivia Schmoedown. We have the number 10 ranked contender, Mike the Killer Kalinowski, at 1-0, going up against the Godfather, not the sheriff anymore, the Godfather, Drew McWeeny, who is also 1-0, the number 9 ranked contender.
We're going to learn more about these competitors. How did they get their nicknames? Is McWeeny actually in the mafia? Has Kalinowski actually murdered people before? One of them is going to emerge as a top contender going forward in the Schmoedown after today's match.
Well, we're going to find out a little bit more about them right now.
Well, I am back now. I had my first match with Ashley the Robin Robinson, like Jason Todd Robin. I buried a Robin, and now I've got a taste for blood. I'm in the match now. You know, I know you guys don't know me. You know, I think I made a strong showing in my first match. I would have liked to have gone three rounds. I'd like to see how I could do. Unfortunately, the way the killer works, he took care of his competition pretty early on, so I got a taste for blood now. Now I'm in it.
So last time I was here, I was billed as the sheriff, but after going away and thinking about it, really what I bring to this league is I have been around longer. And I have seen more. So I feel more like I am the Godfather. And that's what I'm going to come in and I'm going to prove over the course of these next set of matches.
You know, these guys out here, these guys know their stuff. I'm not trying to come in here all, you know, screaming, shouting a big match. I respect these guys that I'm up against right now. I'm going to work my way up the ladder and prove myself.
Well, it's interesting because I had heard people, when I came in, people were talking about what Bibiani had done during his first match. And so now the question is, do I feel like I'm going to compare myself to him? And again, this goes back to the age thing. I'll just say that the first time I met Bibiani, he told me that he got into this business because he was reading me when he was growing up. I think that says it all.
Oh, Drew McWeeny, I do respect you. You were at the birth of the internet like this, but you've got strength weaknesses just like everyone else. I can see you might lose focus on this, and it's going to come down. I hope you bring me to the third round. I hope I get to go to that third round. A lot of people were talking. They want to see how I'm going to do in that final round. Hopefully, you're strong enough to get me there into that third round, but after that, all she wrote.
Mike, you seem like a really nice guy. I'm sorry what I'm going to have to do to you today, but I have to do it. So in advance, if you cry, at least put it on video. I'd like to see it.
Well, Well, there you go. They both are looking to make a name for themselves.
And some trash talking. Good. It's good to see little mini John Rochas.
Well, you see what I don't see. I don't think Drew McWeeny sees himself as a mini anything. I think he is a guy that wants to put his stamp, and he is saying he's been around before any of us were ever here. He is the Godfather. He is the one that is going to be the champion. But in order to do that, he's got to get past the killer.
It's interesting you say that, because when the competitors were out doing their pregame stretching before the show, I saw McWeeny look at his name, and he's the favorite today against Kalinowski, and you just saw a glow in his eyes like a little kid opening the Millennium Falcon on Christmas for the very first time. Will his career go into hyperspace? We're about to find out.
Well, here is the tale of the tape. You've got Mike Killer Kalinowski. His strengths are comic book movies, 80s movies, and making a list and checking it twice.
And maybe killing people. We don't know.
Well, I was trying to be nice about it. And then you've got the Godfather, Drew McWeeny. Classics, comic book movies, and changing names whenever he wants to.
And leaving the gun, possibly taking a cannoli.
Are you ready to start this thing?
Let's do this, Christian. Get that golden throat warmed up, because it is championship week. The finals are here.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Movie Trivia Schmoedown. Introducing first, representing DC Movie News, with a record of one win, no defeats, with one knockout, he is the ranked number 10 contender, Mike the Killer Kalinowski!
Here comes the kid, dressed in all black, like a really tough limo driver. This is a guy you want driving your Lyft around town.
Very impressive first match against Ashley, the Robin Robinson. TK.
Oh, he's shooting the fan.
He's a showman at heart. Look at him, he's ready to play, and he doesn't look fazed at all.
He is probably the best looking gentleman we've had on the show.
I've been on the show.
I am willing to say, I bet Kalinowski smells great too.
Oh, that's getting weird. And his opponent. We got guns. Representing the podcast 80s All Over.
We know this music.
With a record of one win, no defeats.
There he is.
He is the ranked number 9 contender, the Godfather, Drew McWeeny.
Christian, very, very businesslike. He comes out, he gives Kalinowski a dirty look, and he goes down, and somebody provided him with his own beverage. How is that going to factor into the match? Is he going to be too jacked up on Mountain Dew to compete?
Or will it be like his spinach, like Popeye? Remember that show?
All right, yeah.
All right.
I remember Popeye.
Are you ready? Mark, why don't you go ahead and tell him the rules for round number 1.
Mr. McWeeny, Mr. Kalinowski, good to have you both here today. Round 1 is simply you will each get 8 questions. It's the same question from 8 different movie categories. You have 15 seconds to write down the answer on the dry erase board you have in front of you. Once time is up, simply hold up your answer. At the same time, verbalize your answer. There's no penalty for missing a point. If you get it right, it's worth 1 point. Obviously, there's no stealing in round 1.
All right, guys, are you ready to go? All right, here we go. Drew McWeeny, very silent.
Just not ready a to go to chatty work. Bunch.
No, they want to get going. They want to start. All right, starting off, your first category is in the category of animated films. In which decade was the first Ferngully film released? In which decade was the first Ferngully film released?
How many of those movies have you seen?
I've seen Avatar.
I've seen, I believe there's 8 Ferngully movies.
5, 4.
James Cameron working on
3,
another 4.
2, 1. All right, Mike, what do you got?
80s.
Drew?
1990s.
90s is correct for 1 point.
McWeeny
on the board.
Has
okay.
An 80s feel to it. Now we move on to action adventure, and your question is this. Norman Reedus and Sean Patrick Flannery play a set of fraternal twins in what film?
I like that. Both those guys.
You ever seen twins in person? Like actual twins? It's scary.
So DeVito and Schwarzenegger on ice.
Say it.
3,
really?
2,
it's a
one.
Hell of a show.
Drew McWeeny.
Boondock Saints.
That's correct, Mike.
Boondock Saints.
All right, there you go. They're both 2-1.
Kalinowski on the board. McWeeny retains the lead.
All right, in the category of comedy, what is the first name of Dr. Evil's son in the Austin Powers films? Now, that movie I like very much.
Very, very
the
funny.
The first and second one.
First right. And third one for me.
Oh, all right. All right. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, Mike.
Scott.
Correct for 1 point.
Scott.
Correct for 1 point. All right, there you go. 3, 2. McWeeny has not missed.
These guys answering questions like it's jury duty for them, Christian.
All right. Here we go.
It's like a library in here. We move on to drama. Your question is, consigliere Tom Hagen is played by whom in the Godfather films? Well, I think I know one guy that might
get
that question right.
Like I said, predetermined categories. Predetermined categories. All right. 3, 2, 1. All right, Drew.
Robert Duvall.
Correct for 1 point.
Robert Duvall.
Correct for 1 point. Kalinowski starting to play really well.
Yeah, they're staring each other down.
All right, next category in the category of family films. James Cromwell plays Farmer Hoggett, or Hoggett, however you want to pronounce it, in what movie? James Cromwell plays Farmer Hoggett in what movie?
Oh, I'm glad you settled on a pronunciation.
Well,
there.
I had to battle with myself. All right, 3, 2, 1. All right, Mike.
Babe.
Correct for 1 point. Drew.
That would be Babe.
That's correct for 1 point.
See that
right.
Pig singing? It is adorable
this
to
is
this
a good, good match here. 5-4 so far.
Here we go, gentlemen. In the world of fantasy science fiction, your question is, an invading army of aliens are called mimics in what 2014 sci-fi flick?
Mimic.
No, not the Mira Sorvino classic.
No, I was waiting for you to set it up so you'd mimic me. Forget it. All right, 3 and 2. One.
And a one.
Oh, there you go, Drew. You
edge
can go first. Sure. And Mike.
I said Edge of Tomorrow or Live, Die, Repeat.
Ooh. Okay, that works. That works. It's showing. That works.
Look at the big brain on Kalinowski.
There you go. I like that.
You know what? I'm taking 3 of his points away just for showing off a little bit too much.
I wouldn't. He's better looking than you are. All right. And
he smells good.
Not final. Next category is a category of horror thriller. Horror thriller. Which thriller has an ensemble cast including John Cusack as a limo driver and Amanda Peet as a Las Vegas prostitute?
We should cosplay as that.
And you want to be Amanda Peet, I get it.
Yeah, I'm going to be Amanda.
No?
All right,
fine.
You know, wait, you be a
3
Vegas prostitute? Come on.
2, 1. All right, pens down, Mike. All right, and Mike.
Nothing?
All right, no points for Mike. And Drew.
Identity.
That is correct. Woo-hoo. Drew McWeeny's been perfect so far. All right.
In order to throw a perfect first round, the last category, the wild card, is going to be romantic comedies. Gentlemen, you guys both have ribald senses of humor so far today. Your question is, name a star of the 2005 Rob Reiner film, Rumor Has It. Name one star. 2005 Rob Reiner film, Rumor Has It.
I think the producers were trying to find one of those, too. Movie didn't do very well. 3.
That joke crushed, though.
Hey, if I had a dollar for every joke to bomb with you, buddy, we'd be rich.
That joke's do this opening
show.
The
3,
box office.
2, 1. All right, Drew.
I was going to write Jennifer Aniston.
You didn't write it down, though. So you didn't write it down, though.
No, didn't write it down.
And Mike.
Mark Ruffalo.
Yeah.
That is correct. Jennifer Aniston would have been correct.
Uh-huh.
So, but it does not count. So we got 7-6. As we get into round number 2.
Round number 2 is where we're going to be introducing
a brand new friend of the show.
An old friend, a new friend.
Ladies and gentlemen, the new
Look
wheel is here.
Beauty.
The new wheel is debuting with Kalinowski McWeeny. And I have to give all the credit in the world to Andrew
that.
From Mad Hatter Productions and Steve Alt for making this wonderful wheel. It is an all handcrafted. It was custom made for the Schmoedown. They're fans. Thank you to both Andrew and Steve for a wonderful wheel. And Andrew and his lovely wife made my daughter a nice customized Star Wars hat. This is fantastic stuff, guys. Thank you so much for that. And now we're going to try this wheel out. Macuga bringing out the wheel.
Yeah, Macuga, no longer the best looking thing in this studio. That wheel is
fantastic. Like a lot more work now.
All right, Mark, why don't you go ahead and tell them how this round works.
Okay, gentlemen. Well, Drew, since you are in the lead, you will get your choices to whether you want to be the very first person to spin that wheel or you're allowed to defer to Mr. Kalinowski. You guys each get a spin of the wheel. If you don't like the category you spun, you are allowed to spin again. Whatever category lands on, you must take. You're going to get a series of 4 questions from that category. Each question is worth 2 points. However, if you're not sure about the answer, you can go to multiple choice, at which point the value of the question goes down to 1 point. Keep in mind, there is stealing in round 2.
All right, so Drew, would you like to go first or second?
I'm going to go second.
You're going to go second. All right, Mike, you will be the first person to spin the new wheel. Give it a good spin, please, and see what you get. Kalinowski putting
Good spin. Oh, look at that thing go round.
Amazing.
And round.
What a debut, and it's going to land on
90s.
Landing on 90s. Would you like to stay with 90s, or would you like to spin again?
You live in that decade.
Huh. You know, I'm going to stay with it.
He's going to stay with it. All right, there we go.
Stay with it.
All right, I will be asking the questions to Mike Kalinowski for 90s movies. Remember, again, Mike, you have 15 seconds to answer each question. And, Drew, you can steal if he misses.
Okay.
All right, here we go. In what United States city does the film The Craft take place?
Multiple choice.
Is it A, Los Angeles, B, New York, C, Chicago, D, Miami?
Chicago.
It's incorrect. Drew?
Los Angeles.
Correct for one point. All right, Drew McWeeny up 8-6.
I would have gone Chicago, too. Good pizza, a lot of witchcraft going on.
Question number two. What was the main hobby of the dude and Walter in the Coen brothers' The Big Lebowski?
Bowling.
That's correct for 2 points. Mike Kalinowski ties it up. Question three. What conflict served as the backdrop for the 1998's The Mask of Zorro?
It was California seceding from the United States with Spain.
Which war was it?
Which war was it?
Five. Four.
Can I take multiple choice?
Not anymore.
Okay. Spanish War.
Can't accept that. And Drew?
The Mexican-American War?
That's correct for 2 points.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Tepid applause from the crowd. Not sure how to feel about that one.
All right. And your final question. What was Jim Carrey's character's full name in The Truman Show?
Multiple choice.
A, Truman Warner. B, Truman Burbank. C, Truman Ellis. D, Truman Eubanks.
Truman Burbank.
Correct for 1 point. All right, 10-9.
10-9. Keeping it close, but McWeeny, a couple big steals in there. Depending on the category he spins, that could have a huge effect on round two.
He could do some damage here if he gets the right category. All right, Drew, go ahead and spin.
Okay.
Give it a good spin.
Let's see.
Tell you what, man, that...
I've never seen that in the history
of this tournament.
And does it pay off? And it's going to land on almost there.
Oh, I love the drama,
Oh, and it's Spinner's Choice. Wait. Spinner's Choice.
Okay,
you can choose anything on the board.
I'll take 70s.
70s movies, all right.
Going all the way back to the 1970s. That was the year the internet was invented.
Right, and Drew invented
it. Impressive.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right, here we go.
All right. Mr. McWeeny, your first question in the world of 1970s movies. This 1974 comedy features Kenneth Mars, Marty Feldman, and Madeline Kahn. Name the film.
It's Young Frankenstein.
Walk This Way. It is a classic. 2 points right off the bat.
Drew McWeeny. And he silenced the crowd.
Your next question. What 1971 film's protagonist is a half-Caucasian, half-American Navajo Indian, a Green Beret Vietnam War vet, and a Hapkido master? Sounds like my life.
Billy Jack.
Wow. Two more points. For Drew McWeeny. Starting to flex that muscle.
He is.
Your next question. What thriller was directed by John Schlesinger, starred Roy Scheider, Laurence Olivier, and William Devane?
Marathon Man.
Christian, he's on fire. I don't know how to put this thing out.
Starting to put it out of reach for Kalinowski here.
All right. Your next question. Who played Sonny's bank robbing partner, Sal, in 1975's Dog Day Afternoon?
The great John Cazale.
Wow. He is great, too. Drew McWeeny. busting open a 9-point gap.
And I'll show you how important that last point for Kalinowski was, because we're able to get into third round and avoids a knockout here. But
he's going to have to get some questions right to force McWeeny's hand.
Now let's get into round number three. Mark, how does round three work?
Gentlemen, round number three, you will each give us a set of numbers. We need three numbers from each competitor. Those numbers can range from 1 to 25. They all correspond to a category here at the desk. Each question ranges in value from 1 to 3 to 5 points. Mr. Kalinowski, you are going to be going first, but Drew McWeeny, since you're in the lead, you get to give us your numbers first. Which three numbers would you care?
2, 8, and 11.
2, 8, and 11. All right, Mike.
7, 14, and 19.
7, 14, and 19 from Mike. All right, Mike, you have to answer all three of your questions in order to tie the game. If you miss one, Drew McWeeny will win via TKO. All right, Mike, you picked category 7 in order to stay in the game. Your 1-pointer for scores and soundtracks. William Bibbiani's best friend. All right. Who composed the score for Back to the Future?
Alan Silvestri.
Correct for
He's
one.
Still
point.
Alive.
Still alive.
Still alive.
Keeps himself alive there.
Scrapping, he's clawing.
Trying to avoid the TKO. 14. Category 14, you chose biopics. The 3-pointer. The 1993 biopic, What's Love Got to Do with It, is about what acclaimed musician's rights to stardom?
Tina Turner.
Correct
What's
for 3 points.
Got to do?
All right, so in order to tie the game, you picked category number 19, which is DiCaprio movies.
He's simply the best.
All right, in what 2008 film does Leo play alongside Russell Crowe as a CIA operative by the name of Roger Ferris, who is attempting to hunt down a terrorist in the Middle East?
Not what I thought it was.
Five, four, three, two.
Blood Diamond.
And your winner by way of technical knockout, the Godfather, Drew McWeeny.
So Drew McWeeny gets the victory, but Kalinowski really gave a nice game effort. He could have just walked away with his tail between his legs entering the third round. He tried his best.
And the answer was Body of Lies. Body of Lies was the answer, and like you said, what a fight there between McWeeny and Kalinowski. Man, that was a great way to start off this event. We're going to have the champion Dan Murrell and John Rocha coming up, but you're going to see, look, I told you, Drew McWeeny, you're going to see this guy soon. And I can also say that he is going to be playing the winner of the Insnider, Jeff Snyder, and the wild man, Josh McCuga. Whoever wins that match will play McWeeny for a chance to get a title shot down the line. We'll see what's going to happen. But before we move to our title shot tonight, let's talk to both McWeeny and Kalinowski, who are with Emma Fyfe.
What is up, Movie Trivia Schmoedown fans? I'm Emma Fyfe here with your winner, Drew the Godfather McWeeny. Drew, how are you feeling after that victory?
I'm feeling very good now. I think I have the rhythm of the Schmoedown. I think I'm starting to figure out how this works. So, yeah, it feels good.
Yeah, you're proving to be a pretty big contender in this league, if I do say so myself.
Well, I know the knowledge is in there. It's a question whether or not you can do it while you're sitting there next to somebody else, and that's really the key to this. And so far, good competitors. I thought there was a strong comeback here, but yeah, I think I'm going to eat everybody's lunch eventually. So,
do you have any particular people in the Schmoedown that you're gunning for, that you're coming after?
Look, I have a few friends in the league, and
all right.
And I'd like to see them all cry. So,
okay, you want to drop some names?
Jeff Snyder. I'd really like to see a few tears. Just a few. And William Bibbiani. If I could make him or Mark Andreyko cry, I mean, man, that'd be a good day.
It definitely, definitely would. So, yeah, I think we're going to see really good things from you, McWeeny. Is there anything that you're nervous about going forward in the Schmoedown?
It's a matter of keeping my facts straight.
And
getting, you know, and not crumbling under the lights. But so far, so good. I feel like so far I haven't had that home stretch challenge where I really had to fight. I'm looking forward to that. I'm sure there's some people that are going to really put me on the ropes in this.
Do you have a Movie Trivia Schmoedown training regimen?
No, I continue to watch everything.
Sounds like a solid plan. Well, congratulations to you, McWeeny.
Thank you.
That we will see amazing things from you in the future. You're proving to be one of the big up-and-comers here in the Schmoedown, and we'll be back in just a moment with Mike Kalinowski. All right, I am here with the unfortunately not victorious Mike the Killer Kalinowski. Mike, you really hung on there.
It was I had a good comeback there.
It's true.
It was that second round. I got a little ahead of myself going into it. I saw what was on the wheel. And when I got 90s, I weighed my options with the other, what I had up there, and I felt pretty good. 90s was a good era for movies with me. Unfortunately, it wasn't. I had one on there. There was one that I really wanted, but the odds did not look in my favor for that, and it backfired big time on me.
Absolutely. I supported your choice to do 90s. I was like, I feel like you
most people
this.
Like 90s, yeah. And that was it's a wide berth in there. But unfortunately, I got a couple in there that weren't that strong with me. The Zorro question, I'm a little upset at myself for that one. That's one of my favorite movies. So.
I mean, you did what you had to do. You played smart. You went multiple choice
and
you weren't sure of the answer.
Right.
You know, unfortunately, it just didn't quite get you enough points to avoid getting that
My
TKO.
First match, the wheel was my friend, and this one, it was not. And when he picked 70s, that's a category you go after when you're hungry. And this guy, my hat's off to him. He earns my respect for that. If he even didn't win, if I beat him, that round with the wheel, number two, that man earned my respect for that.
Yeah, he totally ran
Absolutely.
That round. But neither of you were given an inch in that first round.
No,
there.
It was good. We were going toe-to-toe. I studied this guy coming into this and watching his stuff. He knows his stuff. And so I wanted a challenge and now put me in my place. So I've got a plan set for the next one.
All right. Well, that suggests that there's going to be a next
one. Oh, absolutely. I'm not done.
All right. Who do you want to take on next?
I'm going to leave in suspense. There's a hit list out there. The people on Twitter, they know who the hit list is. People just keep adding themselves. McWeeny, he put himself on there. I was like, all right, unfortunately, didn't go my way in this one, but that's all right.
All right.
You know, you get knocked down, you get back up. And so I look to Rocha as the man who, I don't say I aspired him, but that man got knocked down, got all the crap for it, and look at him now.
That's true.
So that is a true way in this competition I like. You know, the sportsman about it, there's a sportsman about it and a way to go about it. And I have my list set. And there's still lists on there. Just knock down. Just got to study and go back for it.
How would you feel if McWeeny went on to be a champion? Would you feel better about losing to him, or would you still be gunning to take him down?
No, because it was a strong fight. I didn't lose to someone because of stupid mistakes. I didn't make stupid mistakes. We got in it. I got myself back in the fight, and I thought a third round was good for me until that last question. It was on the tip of my tongue, but that movie is. I don't think anyone remembers that movie, but it was a tough one. So I felt good about it losing to him. If he goes on, hats off to him. But then I'll go after even more. It's kind of like dangling that carrot in front of me.
Well, I think both of you are proving to be very serious contenders here in the Schmoedown, so we certainly expect to see great things from you in the future.
Hopefully.
Sorry for your loss today, but it was a match well fought.
Absolutely.
Back to you, Mark and Christian.
Fantasy update. What's up, Schmoedown fans? Josh McCougar here with your fantasy update. Big undercard match here with Mike Kalinowski and Drew McWeeny. Drew McWeeny scoring a big 18 points. Hold on to McWeeny. That guy is obviously a buzzsaw. He has the winner of me and Jeff Snyder. I don't know if he's ever gotten a question wrong. If he did, it was totally on accident and he forgot to write it on the whiteboard. He is a madman. If you don't have him on your team, try and make a trade. I don't know. Sell your first kid. That guy is awesome. If you're trying to win a fantasy league, draft Drew McWeeny. Mike Kalinowski, on the other hand, split that 13.5. You get 6.5 solid points. He's not out. He dresses well. He shoots that black glove really well. Not sure exactly what that means. We'll have to know more in the future. Mike Kalinowski, hold on to him or trade for him. Fantasy update. Hot.
Oh, Danny boy. Danny boy, the pipes are playing. It's time. Dan, it's time. It's time to face the outlaw. It's time to go toe-to-toe with the best there is, the best there ever was, and the best there ever will be.
That's right, Schmoedown fans. I'm back, and I'm back to defend this thing. Guess how many people have defended this title as many times as I have? The answer is zero. None.
What did I tell you from the beginning? I wanted the belt. I want all the belts, all the records. You're in my way. You've enjoyed it. You've had a nice run. You're a good champion. Love you. You did nice work. But it's time for a real champion. A champion that the people love, the people hate, the people enjoy, the people can't take their eyes off. And that's me.
And for all of you people that I hear on the internet, yap, yap, yap in their mouth, starting with John Rocha, but this isn't just about John Rocha. This is about respect. When I fought John Campia, they said I couldn't beat him, and I did. When I fought Clark Wolf, they said I couldn't beat her, and I did. When I fought Mance, you're going to lose to Mance. When I fought Riley, you're going to lose to Riley. When I fought Ellis, you're going to lose to Ellis. I beat Ellis. Oh, you didn't beat Ellis by enough. This isn't about winning. This isn't about a championship. This isn't about beating John Rocha. This is about respect.
The dust settles. This epic battle between you and me, Dan. I have that belt around my waist. I'll have earned your respect. And I'll earn the respect of everyone else who doubted me. I eat your doubt. I drink your haters' tears. They motivate me. They bring me fire. And when it's all done, you'll know you got beat by the once future champ, the Outlaw.
I am the Schmoedown champion. I don't want to talk about the belt going back to anywhere. The belt stays with me. Mr. Nice Guy is gone. And the champ is here.
Back, we are back, and you look, what a great first match there.
Yeah,
Kalinowski and McWeeny, with McWeeny crushing it. TKO, mm-hmm. McWeeny is someone that could easily be facing for a title sooner or later.
Whatever you're comfortable with saying as far as an analogy standpoint, maybe they were the jalapeno poppers or the guacamole dip. They were the appetizer to the main dish. Christian, if we're at Chili's, the baby back ribs are about to happen.
That is very, very true, my friend. We are ready for the main event. And before we get to the main event, it falls on you guys. If you want to see more matches like this, if you want to see a potential big matches like we keep teasing that Rock versus Kevin Hart match, if you want to see all these big matches and more matches and stuff of that nature, it's on you. Click like, comment, keep doing that. Join the Movie Trivia Facebook Schmoedown page. Make sure you do that and find out more stats. Talk to your favorite competitors. All that stuff, that's on you to do that too. That's what we're doing here today, ready for this big championship match. And what a championship match it is. It is the Outlaw, John Rocha, the number one contender, going up against Dangerous Dan Murrell. 5-0, the undefeated champion, who arguably is one of the best we've seen at this game.
That's right. You talk about a clash of styles so often, and it really is going to factor in here because John Rocha literally rode a horse to today's event at the studio. Dan Murrell, probably more of a Prius guy, a little more progressive, and that's how their characteristics are. John Rocha, very aggressive. He gets excited about this. Murrell, cool, calm, casual, but he walks onto that stage and he knocks it out of the park. He is still undefeated. I believe he's going for his sixth victory in a row.
He's going for his sixth victory, which will be the most of all time. He's the fastest to ever get to 5-0. He has three knockouts. He is the only person to defend it twice. He's going for his third defense now. He has been an absolute madman in this league, and we're going to see what he can do against Rocha, who everything Rocha, from the day I asked him to be part of this, he wants to be the champion. Their roads are very different, and let's see how they came to be right now.
Championship is on the line. Friendship doesn't mean anything. Co-workers don't mean anything. Or I don't care if it's you. I don't care if it's Ellis or Harloff or Mance. When the championship's on the line, I come to play.
You don't care if it's me. Whoa. Whoa. If I, Dan, and I'll listen, no offense, but if I were you and I'd had the title, I'd have stayed a fighting champion. I'd have fought through the rounds. I don't know, but that's just me. I mean, that's just me. But I know you had to choose what you had to choose. Maybe you're exhausted and tired from answering all the questions. But listen, Dan.
Well, listen, carrying this belt around is pretty heavy, so it's a hard work. You got to rest up sometimes.
I'm going to hate you.
When you're a champion, you do your talking in the ring, which is where I plan to do it.
I like being the champ. I like testing people. I like people coming after me to be the champ. And if I can be the champ on more than one front, I'm happy to do it. Ruby fights, Schmoedown. I want every belt. I want to get in shape and fight in the WWE. I want to win all their belts, too. I want to have a wall of belts.
What I want is Dan Murrell. Dan Murrell has the belt. Like everyone else through this entire run, they've all just been in the way of the belt. Bestman is the best thing that ever happened to me. Bestman got me going. Bestman got me motivated. Bestman got me focused. But then to keep coming back and keep winning, that's the difference. That's
That's why people follow the Outlaw, because they follow winners.
Andy Signor, give John Rocha a shot at the movie fights belt before I face him for the Schmoedown belt. Yes. You know how I got my title shot? I earned it.
Yes.
I won. Yeah. John Rocha is 1-5 on movie fights. We don't give a title fight to some scrub who's won one game out of six. Yes. You already get to face me for one title. You don't want to face me for another, my friend.
When you speak things into action, into the universe, things happen. If you commit, you focus, and you fight, even when you're down. I was down, I fought back and won, and that's what it takes. I don't have a belt around me now, but I have a shot for another one.
Roka's got a great trivia mind. Personally, am I scared of him? No, I mean, he's got a lot of talk, but I don't see him with any of these.
Listen, you and me, you gotta worry about it. You gonna hold on to that belt when I face you? I don't think so. I've been working my ass off to fight Dan Murrell, and now the time has come.
Want to face the absolute best of the best to win this belt.
I want all the records. I want all the belts. I want all the records.
So you look at that story. I mean, you get psyched up. You know, this is the battle. I mean, Rocha almost had his shot after the Schmoedown Spectacular. You took that away from him.
Damn,
and then
right
you battled this guy.
And then I went toe-to-toe with Murrell. I took him as far as he's ever been before, which sounds a little awkward in retrospect. But, Christian, these guys live for this moment. And I don't know if Rocha just didn't get enough belts growing up, but he wants one so bad.
So badly.
Can he take the one from Murrell today? I don't know that anybody ever could, but if somebody wants it badder than Rocha, I haven't met them yet.
Yeah, and the very interesting part is that I saw a couple of horsemen around too. I didn't see much of the Lion's Den. I know Dan has had some issues with the way the Lion's Den handled that whole Andraco thing, and I haven't seen one of the Lion's Den here tonight. So we'll figure all that stuff out, but I'm ready to go. Here's the tale of the tape. John Rocha, strengths are biopics, action adventure, and running his mouth loudly. And then you've got Dangerous, Dan Murrell, Spielberg movies, Oscar movies, and smacking everyone around in this league.
Christian, they both love hats. They both love wearing sunglasses and jackets, but they're not sitting in the back of a porn theater. They're ready to sit on the center of the stage and answer some movie trivia.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Movie Trivia Schmoedown. Five rounds for the undisputed Movie Trivia Schmoedown Championship of the World. First, the challenger, representing the Four Horsemen, with a record of 5 wins, 2 defeats. He is the 2016 Ultimate Schmoedown finalist and the former Movie Trivia Schmoedown team champion and the number one contender, the Outlaw, John Rocha!
The beast emerges!
Oh, a nose comes out
afterwards. The nose emerges!
There he is!
And there's the Outlaw!
Oh, he's ready, flashing the four.
Flashing the four.
Burnett could not be here tonight, but he's here in spirit, and look at his team supporting him. This is everything he has waited for. This is his moment. Can he deliver on the moment?
Maybe the thing he needed to get him over the edge was having a group of teammates who truly believe in him. Clearly that is the case with the Four Horsemen, but he's going to be the lead dog and the only one on that stage.
And his opponent needing no introduction in the Schmoedown universe. Representing Screen Junkies.
I know that music.
With a record of 5 wins, no defeats. He is the 2016 Movie Trivia Schmoedown Player of the Year. He is the reigning Screen Junkies Movie Fights Champion, the reigning Screen Junkies TV Fights Champion, and the reigning, defending, undefeated, undisputed Movie Trivia Schmoedown Champion of the World, Dangerous Dan
Murrell! There comes, look at all of the hardware!
Wow! Look at the blitz.
Oh, he's got his glasses on. And, oh, he's throwing
he
glasses
the glasses
floor.
Off. He's
Wait.
Done.
Oh, he steps on his glasses!
Wow!
Let's go! Chiropractors everywhere is freaking out.
Wow.
It takes an hour to build glasses, but only a second to stop them.
Holy, but look at Murrell putting the belt on Rocha's hand.
Clearly within reach, Christian. Wow. Tantalizingly close, like a pie cooling on the edge of a window.
You can cut the tension with a knife, and look at the Beast. The Beast giving a nice massage. Look at
Beast
that.
Has been rubbing his shoulders for a good 5 minutes now.
All right, growl, Beast. Growl. All right, growl your way out of there. All right, let's go.
No happy ending for Rocha.
All right, guys, this is it. This is the championship. We are ready to go. Any other?
I want to say something right
yes.
now.
Yes, all right, there you go.
Of course you do.
Danny boy, did you enjoy having the belt for a little while? Because it's time to give it to me.
Are you going to clean it for me? And
I don't even want to have the match. I just want to watch them talk to each other.
Oh, no, no.
It's so good. All right, these guys have been going at it for a while, and we're ready to come down 5 rounds, gentlemen, for the Undisputed Movie Trivia Schmoedown Championship. Mark, please tell them how round one works.
Gentlemen, round one of your championship match will be like most round ones. You will get 8 questions from 8 different movie categories. Each question is worth 1 point. You will have 15 seconds to write your answer on the dry erase board in front of you. Once you are asked to reveal your answer, please show the whiteboard towards the viewers and then say it at the same time. There's no penalty for missing a question. And again, each question is worth 1 point.
All right, Rocha, please stop chewing gum into the microphone.
Not chew gum into the microphone.
That would be great. Thank you so much. All right, here we go. Let's start it up.
Let's make it happen.
In the category of animated, a character named Lucy Wilde uses a lipstick taser in which film franchise?
You ever been tased before?
Yes, but I don't remember it. Does that count?
That's usually the way tasings happen.
So I can't really prove that it happened. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Dan?
Madagascar?
Incorrect.
No clue.
What a bunch of dopes!
Looking for Despicable Me. Despicable Me is what we're looking
Despicable
for.
Me.
All right, here we go, Mark.
We move
Not
on
down
to
with the
Action Adventure.
Universal Studios property, too. That's in shame.
Jason Statham plays Frank Martin in what film series? You want to do your Statham? You have the floor.
My voice hurts.
No, you got to do Statham. This is the championship match.
I don't think I can do it. I'll embarrass myself.
This is what Christian's
Five,
Jason Statham sounds like.
4, 3.
I'm Statham.
2, 1. Rocha.
The Transporter.
That correct. Is correct, Dan.
Transporter.
Correct. Tie game. They're all awake.
Right. All right, there we go. All right, here we go. Category 3 in the category of comedy. In what city does the climactic bowling tournament take place in Kingpin?
Highest score you ever rolled? I got 181.
I got 180.
You lied, but you went below me. Thank you.
You're welcome. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Dan.
St. Louis?
Incorrect. John?
Las Vegas?
Incorrect. Looking for Reno, Nevada. Reno.
Close enough, man. Come on.
But huge props to Dan Murrell promoting my shows at the St. Louis Funny Bone tonight.
Half points.
Okay. All right. Here we go.
That's actually happening.
Yeah, you taking a DeLorean?
All right. I'm flying out of Burbank.
I love that. All right. Here we go. Mark, category 4.
Drama. Who starred as Tom Booker in the 1998 film The Horse Whisperer?
Good old Horse Whisperer.
Whispered.
You ever do a horse?
You're like, hey, buddy. Hey, you're doing great. Thank you so much. All right. 5, 4. Keep running. 3, 2, 1.
John.
Robert Redford.
Correct. Dan.
Robert Redford.
Correct. Tit for tat. There we go.
All right.
Tight. Tight game so far. All right. Category of family films. Name the Being John Malkovich director who also helmed 2009's Where the Wild Things Are. I did
hated
not like that movie.
Yeah, hated
okay,
it.
Good.
Loved
together.
The book. Loved, right. I actually read that book.
All right. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Dan.
Spike Jonze.
Correct.
Spike Jonze.
Correct.
Wow.
All right.
Woo!
Woo! This is the championship match.
Goddamn Reno. Goddamn Reno.
Three questions left in round one. Your next category is fantasy science fiction. Mm. You'll find the Hornburg Fortress in what movie franchise?
You say that again, the what?
The Hornburg Fortress.
Five, four, three, two, and one. John.
Divergent.
Incorrect.
I have no idea.
Incorrect. That would be
Lord of the Rings.
Oh,
Lord of the Lord Rings. Of the Rings.
Oh, wow.
Fortress. Where Helm's
what is this,
Deep
inner geekdom?
Is.
What is this?
All right. Here we go. Category of horror thriller. Which actress starred opposite Alec Baldwin in the 1996 legal thriller, The Juror?
Hard word to say, but you nailed it. Juror.
Juror. JTE could not do that.
he can do a lot of other things.
That's true. 5, 4, 3, 2, and Dan.
Demi Moore.
Correct. John.
Demi Moore.
Wow. All right. They know what they know.
Here we go. Your last category in round one to possibly break this tie. Your wild card category is new releases.
Oh, crap.
New releases.
I don't watch anything.
Probably going to hurt you in this game going yes. forward. With the release of Underworld Blood Wars, how many total films are in the Underworld series?
15 seconds to answer.
I like.
You saw Underworld Blood Wars. I did not.
I was about to lie and say I like those films. I don't like any of them.
You liked it better than Resident Evil.
Well, that's true. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. John.
5.
Correct. Dan.
5.
Wow. We are tied wow. at 5 going into Woo. Round 2.
And that is the beginning of a championship match. All right, Mark, it's time for round number 2.
Good round.
Round 2 works as follows. Each competitor gets a spin at the wheel. If you don't like the category you spun, you are awarded a mulligan. Whatever you spin, you must answer a series of 4 questions based on that topic. Each question is worth 2 points. If you're not sure of the answer, you can check to multiple choice, at which point the value of the question goes down to 1 point. Because we have a tied ball game right now, the decision goes to Dan Murrell. So, Dan, it's up to you. Would you like to spin first, or would you like to allow John Rocha to have the first spin?
I'll let John Rocha have
wow,
the first spin.
Wow, all right.
Sounds good.
Champions on challenge. Oh, no, that's no, real, real, real spin.
Yeah.
Real spin.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. I hope we don't edit that out, because that is funny.
There's the spin.
And I know he's tough little wheel.
And he's going for
horror thriller. Wait, and he's saying no.
That's a negative result.
He's waving it off.
Spinning it. Big vicious spin by the Outlaw.
Oh,
oh, that's animated.
That is
that's
animated.
Animated. That is animated.
Animated.
This is the all worst right. wheel ever. No offense to whoever created it and sent it into Christian and did the Star Wars hat. Love you.
All right. All right, here we go. Outlaw. You hit animated.
Damn it.
What is the name of the boy genius from the 2001 animated film from Nickelodeon that led to a TV series of the same name?
Jimmy Neutron.
Correct for 2 points.
Big watcher of that show. Yeah.
In what Disney animated film do you hear the song Go the Distance?
Hercules.
Correct.
He knows his cartoons.
He does. Dawn of the Dinosaurs is an entry in which animated franchise?
Dawn of the Dinosaurs?
Correct.
Land Before Time.
Incorrect.
Oh, shit.
Ice Age?
Correct. 2
Damn.
Points.
That's a big steal. Big steal
big
right
steal.
There.
I wonder why. You're staying away from multiple.
Should have gone multiple choice.
All right, here we go. Last question. Who provided the voice of Queen Lillian in Shrek 2 and Shrek the Third?
Julie Andrews.
Correct for 2 points. So minus that steal, 11-7. I'm probably questioning why he didn't go to multiple choice in that one.
That's right, but sometimes he gets a little excitable, like that cute squirrel in Ice Age, the only redeeming quality of any of those films.
So now it's up to the champion. He will be giving a big spin here. Here we go. I know he's looking. What he's looking for?
I think he's trying to get a feel as to how hard you need to spin that wheel.
Mixed bag.
Mixed bag.
Mixed bag. It's a big question mark with loot inside.
Can I get some clarification on the mixed bag? Is that just?
It could be anything.
Could be anything.
Could be 4 questions from anything.
Ooh. I mean, if you're a champion.
Oh.
Just saying.
Anything, huh?
You get balls?
Yeah. The temptation for Murrell is strong here
it
right
is.
Now, Christian, but there's some other categories on the wheel he might be better at, some other ones that might befuddle him.
So much. You know, if only to avoid the dreaded movie release dates.
Yes.
I would kill myself if I spend movie release dates on the second one. Let's see what the mixed bag category is all about. Let's do it.
All right. All right. All right. Let's do it.
Mixed bag.
True champion. True champion.
Here we go, Dan. We're reaching deep into that bag. Your first question. Which creature, according to a 1990s horror film, appeared if you said his name 5 times before a mirror?
K. Candyman, and I'm not going to say it the fifth time.
Thank you for sparing everybody here in the studio and our lives. That is correct for 2 points. Your next question, based on the 1974 book, what 1977 movie tells the story of the World War II Allied military operation entitled Operation Market Garden?
Wow.
1974 book?
1974 book. The movie came out in 1977.
Five.
Give me multiple choice.
Is it A, A Bridge Too Far, B, The Bridge on the River Kwai, C, The Bridge at Remagen, or D, The Longest Day?
It's either A or C.
Five.
I'm going to go with
four.
C.
That is incorrect. We go to John Rocha.
I'm going to go with A.
That is correct
for
a point.
Wow, big steal there.
He got his point
one
back.
Point. He got 1 point back out of that.
That's right. He lost 2 points. Right. He gets one back. And now we go to Dan Murrell. Your third question in the mixed bag category. Hook, Sleeping with the Enemy, and The Addams Family were released in what year? Just think about mixed bag. You never know when Scott Mance is going to show up.
That's right.
I told you.
Five.
1991. Four.
He got it down. Wow. 2 points.
Woo.
It's a LeBron shot.
Oh, no. We did that one.
It's a LeBron
3-7.
Damn.
All right. Dan, your last question in mixed bag. What gesture of support does the entire Notre Dame team do to ensure Rudy gets to dress for a game in the film Rudy?
Well, I know what they physically do. I'm trying to see if I phrase it right. They quit. They walk up to the coach and they hand them their jerseys.
We can accept that. That is 2 points. That's they turn points. In their
right.
jerseys.
So the champion nice takes job, a 1 point lead going Ooh. Into round three, which
Damn,
is
got multiple
the
joint.
Jeopardy round. Mark, how does the Jeopardy round work?
The Jeopardy round works as follows. The champion is in the lead, so Dan, you're going to spin that wheel one more time. Whatever category you spin, we're going to ask you guys a question based on that category. Before we ask the question, you have those dry erase boards in front of you. You're going to write down a point value from 0 to 3. That's how many points you're willing to wager on what the question is. You get the question right, you get that many points. You get the question wrong, you lose that many points.
And when you write your points down, you'll show those to Josh McCouga first before we ask the question.
He's the guy in the pink suit.
All right, here we go, guys. So, all right, Dan, please spin the wheel.
Got to warm up to this thing.
Yeah,
that's a hero spin like right that.
Oh.
There we go.
Horror thriller. Horror thriller. All right. So how many points will you guys bet? Write down your points, please. I'm going to give you 10 seconds to decide how many points, and then we're going to ask the question.
Shit.
And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Please write your points.
Damn it.
McCouga, take a look at their points, please.
What do these guys got?
All right, here we go.
Your question in the realm of horror thriller. What actor played oncologist Dr. Lawrence Gordon in 2004's Saw? What actor played oncologist Dr. Lawrence Gordon in 2004's Saw?
Never saw a Saw film.
I see what you did, and I appreciate it, and I will laugh later.
Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Dan, how many points did you bet?
I bet 2 points.
And you bet?
Kerry Elwes.
And Roka, how many points did you
bet? I bet 2 points.
Yeah.
And I bet Kerry Elwes.
Both correct. There we go.
Okay.
You got 15-14 now. Look at that. Going in. What a battle here. Now we got into the dreaded speed round.
Well, Christian, assuming there is room on the table amidst all the jewelry and masks and whatnot, we can put two buzzers up there. We're going to ask you a series of 5 questions. When you know the answer to the question, you can buzz in. Each question is worth 1 point. If you get the question correct, you get a point. If you miss the question, you do lose a point. Once you buzz in, you have 2 seconds to answer the question. There will be a countdown. We have a clock. You get a maximum of 2 seconds, or else it is considered an incorrect answer.
All right.
What is the name of the character played by Robert Shaw in Jaws?
That would be John Rocha.
Quint.
That's correct. In what film will you find a news anchor named Veronica Corningston?
God.
Anchorman.
Damn it!
Correct.
That was a loud damn it by Roca.
How long do you have to live after seeing the tape?
7 days.
Correct.
Also right. Accepted Tie one game. Week.
All right.
Your next question. Name a film starring Matt Damon released before Good Will Hunting.
John Rocha. School Ties.
That's correct.
Yeah. Okay. And your last question. Who directed Pretty Woman?
Oh, fuck. Richard Benjamin.
Out. Out. Okay, so 16-16.
Damn it!
Loses the point. 16-16 as we go into the fifth and final round.
This is what you want. Tied at 16. Opponents getting points left and right. Nobody's getting technically knocked out. Nobody's getting knocked out
here.
This is the championship match we all crave.
All right, Mark, so how does the fifth round work?
Happily, I have the answer to that question. Each of these competitors is going to give us a series of three numbers ranging from 1 to 25. Those numbers correspond up here at the desk to a movie category. Those category questions range from point values of 1 to 3 to 5. Dan Murrell, you are the champion, and thus it is a tied ball game. You get to select your numbers first.
16, 8, and 1.
16, 8, and 1.
Going
John Rocha.
Backwards.
My God, you took two of my numbers. No bullshit. Damn it.
You guys gonna get a coffee after this?
Fuck.
Come on, John.
They're numbers, Mr. Rocha.
Yeah. All right.
5.
10.
4.
18 and 22.
10, 18, and 22? 10, 18, and 22. All right, John Rocha, you are the challenger, so you will go first with your one-pointer, which is category 10, and that is the category of sports movies.
Okay.
Athletics.
Sure. For your one-pointer, in Rookie of the Year, which Major League Baseball team does young Henry Rautgartner play for?
Shit. Rookie of the Year.
5, 4, 3.
Minnesota Twins.
Sorry, looking for the Chicago Cubs. Chicago Cubs. Now it goes back to the champion, Dan Merrill.
You were thinking Little Big League.
Yes.
Yep.
Thinking Little Big League. Dan Murrell, your one-pointer comes from the world of classics. And your question is, you'll hear Marlon Brando yell Stella in what film?
Streetcar Named Desire.
One point for Dan Murrell.
All right, back
one
to John.
One for Dan Murrell.
Back to John Rocha now. Category 18 for your three-pointer. Category of family films. Tony Perkis, played by Ben Stiller, is the name of the fitness guru that takes over a summer camp in what movie?
Can you repeat the question again? I'm sorry.
Tony Perkis, played by Ben Stiller, is the name of the fitness guru that takes over summer camp in what movie?
Ben Stiller? I don't know. A dodgeball. I don't know.
Looking for Heavyweights.
Oh,
Heavyweights. Yeah,
I've never seen it.
You clearly weren't a fat kid. I saw that movie 38 times.
So it comes down to this for John Rocha. He has to hit the 5-pointer or Dan Murrell retains the championship. In the category of dramas, which film sees Jennifer Lopez and Billy Campbell in a failing abusive relationship?
Enough.
Correct for 5 points. Rocha stays alive. But Dan Murrell actually needs to. So with that point, he has forced it. Dan has to hit the 5-pointer no matter what to win. So let's see what happens here. All right. They get to category 8, the 3-pointer for Dan Murrell.
Just a little warm up here as the points play out for Murrell. Your question. What is the name of the location that houses Genie's lamp in Aladdin?
Wow.
The Cave of Wonders?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Wow. All right. There we go. All right. Comes down to this. The final question for Dan Murrell. If he hits it once again, he will retain the title. If he misses it, John Rocha is the new champion. What is the final question?
But first, a word from our sponsor. We're back, Christian. And your category, Dan, to retain the belt, is directors. Directors.
Okay.
Your five-point question for the win. Who directed The Burbs? Five, four, three, two, one.
Barry Levinson.
And your winner! And the new year!
Back into the Outlaw now. Did you hear him squeal right after he got that correct hit? Oh my goodness. I have never seen the Rocha more excited
all
than right now. I'm already yelling for more bells.
What a unbelievable. I mean, that was. Wow, I'm just speechless.
You know, Christian, you break down the match, and it's great to see the Outlaw and all the pomp and circumstance of getting the belt, but let's take a moment to appreciate the greatness of Dangerous Dan.
Are you kidding me?
Here.
That's the best player in the world. Are you kidding me?
Well, he doesn't have the belt anymore, but the run that he went on.
That match was insane. It looked like Rocha was about to, it looked like he was dead in the water in the third round, and he hits the five-pointer. Murrell hits both his one and his three, but the five didn't do it. I mean, this is the game. Holy crap. This is one of the best matches I've ever seen.
Christian, you get the feeling that this was not a be-all, end-all. This was the first in a series of matches that they're going to have.
Oh,
like a classic movie series such as Home Alone.
This is the dream. This is the dream, and he did it. And Murrell showed exactly what Murrell's all about. And you're absolutely right. This is not the last time we'll see Dan Murrell and John Rocha. They'll play again. And we're going to see both of them in the free-for-all. They're going to be in our version of the Royal Rumble. And it looks like we have a big storyline here happen. The Horsemen are back on top now with that victory as their leader is, say it with me, John Rocha is the Movie Trivia Schmoedown champion of the world.
It is
unbelievable.
Hard to believe the Outlaw is holding the belt. Dangerous Dan Murrell proving his nickname as well.
Look at that score. What a match
it
that was.
It doesn't get any closer than that. And for an interview with the winner and the loser of the championship match, we turn it to Emma Fife. It's all yours.
Thanks, guys. I am here with your new Movie Trivia Schmoedown champion, the Outlaw, John Rocha.
Yeah. Hi, Emma.
Hi. How you doing?
I'm speechless, and I'm super excited.
Yeah.
And exhausted. What a match.
You talked a big game going into it, but I know there were some nerves.
Yeah, a lot of nerves, but you know, with Dan Murrell, you can't get too wrapped up. You can't get too crazy because he will take advantage of it. So I was keeping it even keel even when I made the mess-ups. I made the outbursts during the game to release the tension. That's how I do it.
Can I just say one thing? I think my back rub helped.
Yes. Agreed.
Listen.
We had some losses recently as the Four Horsemen, and someone had to step up and win some belts. And I took it off their crown jewel of the Lion's Den. Now I'm the champion, and we're going to come back and be the tag team champions. And this man's going to be the Inner Geekdom champion, and then we're going to have all the belts.
That's
growl.
Yeah.
This was definitely a really big win for the Horsemen, who have been struggling as of late. So you're bringing the belt back to the Horsemen. You're bringing the belt back to Collider.
Yeah.
I got to say, John Rocha, every time there was a category, you acted as if you didn't know anything.
No.
Was that a strategy?
No, not at all. You never can estimate. You never know what's going to pop up. You never know what's going to happen. And with Dan Murrell, you have to be on your toes all the time. He's a great champion. Pushed me to the limit. Pushed me to the edge. Had me play my best game. No tricks. No tricks. I didn't go southpaw. I didn't switch up. No tricks. I fought him straight up and I beat him straight up.
That's absolutely true. Now, going forward, yeah. obviously, a lot of people are going to be coming after you. You know, we're looking at a Mark Riley or a Clark Wolf or a JTE coming up next. Who are you most scared about potentially facing?
I'm not scared of anybody. You line them up, I knock them down. That's how it works. I beat a murderer's row to get here, and I beat the head murderer to win the title. And that's how it works. Whoever's coming up, JTE, yeah, great. Bring him on. Well, he's finally starting to win. Great, took him 3 years. Who else you got? Riley, I beat him twice already. Clark Wolf talks a good game, says she doesn't want the belt. Then when she fights, she gets rattled. I'll rattle her again. And even Bibiani. I know Bibby wants it. He's going to take some time. He's going to earn his keep. And then maybe someday we're going to fight. And then maybe Matt Nost as well. He may want it. You line him up, you knock him down, I knock him down. That's how it works. That's how it works.
Wow, sounds like there might be a little dissent amongst the four horsemen.
Just saying, I respect that they want belts. I respect their hunger and their knowledge.
This is an actual den of lions. Not the posers over there. Yeah. You're all killers in this force.
Yeah, I'm right.
The horses are the real lions.
Brilliant.
Growl, growl.
Great. Put that on a t-shirt. The horses are the real lions. Well, congratulations again, John Rocha. A match well fought and well deserved. We'll be right back with Dan Murrell. All right, we are back with the narrowly defeated, dangerous Dan Murrell. Dan,
yeah.
You are a Schmoedown legend. No matter what the results of this match were today, how are you feeling right now?
You know, every dog has his day. And I'm talking about me, not Rocha, by the way. This is a tough game. People play this game hard. No one's ever going to run through this thing undefeated. I knew this would happen one day. And, I mean, look at the guy that was just here standing here talking to you. I can't think of a guy who would be prouder being the champ and who I would want to face again to get that belt back from than John Rocha.
That is true. John Rocha definitely really, really wanted this belt since day one. But, Dan, I got to tell you, you up there watching you is incredible. You're just – nothing shakes you. Rocha, every question, he's like, oh, I don't know. But you answer without hesitation. I thought you had this, man.
I got shook a little bit. If you go back and look, I actually gave Rocha a point unintentionally. I forgot about stealing, and I narrowed down that multiple choice to A or C, and I took the wrong one. So that was a slip on my part. He might have rattled my cage a little bit, if I'm being honest. That's the kind of mistakes I try not to make. But that was a good, clean game. I hope people enjoyed watching it. It was a hell of a game to play. And like I say, it's I couldn't have asked for a better match for the belt.
Yeah. As I say, win or lose, you're definitely going down in Schmoedown history. What's your plan for getting the belt back?
Well, there's a lot of roads. There's a lot of roads back to the belt. If I have to fight my way back up to the belt, I will do that. I know that there's an event coming up that might give me an avenue to come back.
Yeah, the free-for-all.
The free-for-all, and I'm going to officially submit my name right here and right now. I was hoping that maybe I'd be able to lay my claim to another one of those belts, but if that's the way that I got to get a rematch, then I'll be happy to win that and get my shot back at the belt that way.
On the road back to the belt, who do you think is going to be like the next person to take down? Obviously, besides Rocha, who's the current champion now, who else are you like really trying to get out of the way?
Well, you know, Riley's always got his eyes on that belt. He held it for a long time. People keep, you know, the shark that keeps swimming in my waters that hasn't come up yet is Bibiani. People keep saying that they want to see the two of us go head-to-head. Maybe that's in the near future. I suspect that if I want another shot at that belt up through the ranks, I'm going to have to face him at some point.
I know. The Four Horsemen have really got it out. They're trying to run the entire Schmoedown. So, again, Dan Murrell, great, great job today.
Before we go, though, okay. I want to say something, because you mentioned the Four Horsemen. And
I
saw that Rocha had some horsemen out here with him. And if you notice, I'm standing here alone.
Yeah.
Now, I was told that I'd get some support from this lion's den. I took a lot of heat for joining them, and I thought that maybe if I took that heat, I'd get something out of it. But I'm standing here by myself.
Yeah, I don't see a man in a beard mask anywhere.
I don't know what this stunt is that Finstock pulled, but as a champion and former champion and a player of this game, I don't respect that kind of play. Like I say, what have these guys done for me lately? So to the members of the lion's den, you just lost your alpha because I'm out.
Oh, snap. Dan Murrell dropping the Lion's Den on air here at the conclusion of the Movie Trivia Schmoedown title match. Dan, well, good luck going solo.
It's a new Murrell order, and I'm a free agent, baby.
And back to you, Mark and Christian.
And as we come back, you see a very elated John Rocha, who's with the Horsemen. Very excited. And you see Dan Murrell doing what Dan Murrell does. He's a champion. He's classy. He wants, you know, he gave Rocha all the credit in the world because that's what Murrell does.
He's not going to be fazed by a win. He's not going to get too high or too low. Rocha, on the other hand, could do a pile of blow tonight and kill himself. We don't know how he's going to celebrate the victory. We can only hope the Outlaw rides again in future matchups. And occasionally, he might come across the path of dangerous Dan Murrell, who's going to be waiting for him.
Well, there you go, guys. You have a new champion. He is John Rocha. Make sure that you guys comment, like I said in the beginning of this, keep on doing that. The more matches we have, it's because of you guys. So keep hitting that like. Go to the Movie Trivia Facebook page. Go and talk about the matches. There are conversations about these matches as they go up. Who do you want to see Rocha play next? Who do you want to see Dan Murrell play next? The whole division is shook. And you guys, it's all about you guys. Thank you once again. Keep commenting. For Mark Ellis, I'm Christian Harloff. Holy shit.
What's up, Schmoedown fans? Here with your fantasy update post-championship match between John Rocha, Dan Murrell. If you have both of those or either of those players, big fantasy day. Obviously, with Dan Murrell, you got to split his points in half. John Rocha scored a big, and he gets a 5-point bonus for winning the championship. Now, a lot of you guys have been asking me, hey, Josh, what about Hector Navarro? Do I get a 5-point bonus for him winning and qualifying? No, you just get a 5-point bonus for Hector Navarro winning. He didn't actually qualify for a play-in match to win that 5-point bonus to get into the Inner Geekdom. If Jason Inman plays Hector Navarro, he also does not get a 5-point bonus to get into the championship match. In order to get that 5-point bonus for a championship match, to get into it, you have to have a play-in match, and that match is determined. Winner goes to the championship. That's the only way to get a 5-point bonus in that way. A lot of you have also been asking me, what if I have Team TV Talk? What's going on with that? Drop Team TV Talk. That's not happening anymore. You guys watched the announcement yesterday. I'm going to be picking a partner. It may be David Griffin, but it won't be TV Talk. I can't tell you who I'm picking or what's going to happen. I also have to beat Jeff Snyder in order to get that fantasy possibility of a new team going for a championship belt. Again, reiterate, because I beat Jeff Snyder and I get a chance at the title, I do get a 5-point bonus. If all of that happens, we'll talk more about that when and if it does happen. Again, if you have Dan Murrell, John Rocha, hold on to them. Those guys will get matches, especially John Rocha. The guy calls out everybody, like you said, all the belts, all the records. If you have him, he's a fantasy moneymaker. He is your Megatron. Josh McCuga, back to you guys.
Hey guys, if you like this video, click the thumbs up button. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. It'll help you stay up to date with everything we've got going on here at Collider.